作为我们中国足球人，目前要去直面这种质疑，甚至是一些对我们的批评。
Germany can learn from China, China can learn from Germany, and I think this approach has to be there, and it helps. Always, it's a win-win situation. It helps always both sides.
欢迎关注中外对话，我是本期主持人卞立群。前不久世预赛落下帷幕，中国足球成为全社会关注的焦点。今天的节目是一场足球之约，我们请到克林斯曼和马明宇，让我们欢迎两位足坛大咖。先请克林斯曼跟我们打个招呼。
Yeah, big hello to China from Los Angeles. It's a pleasure to be there.
克林斯曼曾担任过德国国家队、美国国家队主帅，也执教过德甲豪门拜仁慕尼黑等球队。在球员时期，克林斯曼夺得过世界杯和欧洲杯双料冠军，被誉为金色轰炸机。我们再次欢迎克林斯曼。我们今天还请到了中国足坛名宿马明宇，他曾以国足队长的身份出战2002年韩日世界杯，是中国足坛足够有代表性的人物，目前担任中国足协执委。欢迎马明宇指导。
主持人好，于尔根先生好，还有我们的大观众朋友们大家好。
现在呢，中国足球受到了很多的批评，想问马明宇指导，您觉得应该如何应对这些批评？
实际上，每个球员都会面临哈，在球场踢球踢输了哈，来自球迷的批评，甚至是一些谩骂，我觉得是很正常的。那么就是作为我们中国足球人，目前也是就要去直面，哈，直面这种质疑，甚至是哈一些对我们的批评，我觉得要直面。我们要梳理我们过去存在的问题啊，包括我们足球人啊很多很多方面的问题。过去我们哪些东西是不好的，我们要抛弃；好的东西，比如像这个欧洲的哈，包括我们邻居日韩的一些好的东西，我们要去汲取。
Well, I think you know criticism is always there in the world of sport. It's normal. You know, when things are not going so well, then the coaches and the players are blamed.And also obviously the administrators and the owners and the investors. The Premier League was not always the top league in the world. You know, it was a long, long path for the Premier League too. I personally, and Mahi played, he was in Italy too, in Italian football when I was there in the late 80s, beginning of 90s, was the top league in the world because there was Maradona, Careca, Lemao, Gullit, and all these great players. Every league has its up and downs and the league depends on the infrastructure of the country and the federation and the stadiums and the fields and obviously the kids, the youth football. But I think in sports, you take criticism always as a motivation. Every time when you get criticized for something, don't, you know, kind of be disappointed with criticism. You have to take it positively and you have to say, okay, I learn now out of whatever mistake or bad performance.And I go to the next challenge. It's constantly, you constantly go forward and you look at what you can do best in the next week or next month or next year. And I keep my fingers crossed, you know, for Chinese football, that it keeps growing and growing and gets stronger and stronger.
二位认为联赛对于一个国家足球运动的开展有哪些作用？
Well, I think, you know, the Bundesliga is extremely, extremely important because it's... the league that every child dreams about to play for one day. Born and your father passes on the team to you, whatever his favorite team is, if it's Bayern Munich, if it's Hamburg, or if it's Stuttgart or Berlin, doesn't matter. In your neighborhood, everybody plays football. So it's for us normal that we inspire already, you know, towards the big stars in the Bundesliga. So for us, the football, it's just... is so embedded into our spirit, into our culture. We can always talk about football. We can get up with football and we can go to bed with football.
其实我觉得一个国家的联赛啊，它是代表你这个国家足球运动的一个试金石。那么有没有一个是否稳定的一个良好的联赛生态体系是非常重要的。这个联赛的好坏啊，包括对你的足球这个影响。对青少年这个影响是非常大的。刚才尤尔根先生提的非常重要的足球文化，现在哈我们的国家的联赛里边很多俱乐部在注重去实施这种足球文化的东西，但是我觉得远远还不够，我们还得在这方面 把足球的文化的东西也根植到我们的联赛，根植到我们的足球运动当中。
那么德国足球总是能涌现出源源不断的人才，那请问克林斯曼，德国是怎样吸引孩子们去喜欢足球，让他们去踢足球，又是如何培养他们的？
If you find in your neighborhood, you know, other children that play football too, or in school that play when there's a school break or some time and you play football, this is when you develop the energy and the desire to play football. So if your environment plays football, you will play football. You know, I mean, obviously in China, for example, it's ping pong, your table tennis is big. So everybody plays ping pong, you play ping pong. It's normal. It's normal. So I only grew up with football because my entire neighborhood only played football. And in America, I live in America since more than 20 years because a lot of children, you know, play basketball because they see a lot of people play basketball. So I think, you know, when you have an environment that favors a certain sport, and with, in this case now, in our case, it's football, then you become part of it. And then you like it. And that drives then the entire infrastructure of the game.
中国足球可能在这个培养青少年方面近来是有些欠缺的。现在的情况是否有些好转？
我们2015年教育部推行的校园足球开始哈，在校园里面现在的这种环境呢，普及性呢已经达到了。但是呢，我还是想说，还远远不够，因为这个我们的这个特别是精英培训。那么这个另外一个话题就是我们精英培训的需要的教练，好的教练也是远远不够的。所以说现在特别今年我觉得很好的一个变化就是我们教育部推行了校园足球的联赛，这个是个全国联赛，我觉得非常好。那么我相信我们的校园足球在普及走到深化哈，走到精英训练这一块水平会得到大步提高。
那二位认为中国足球和德国足球在哪些领域可以进一步开展合作？克林斯曼，您在2019年曾来过中国，当时给您留下了怎样的印象？
Every cooperation that we can have, you know, between the Bundesliga and the Chinese Super League or between the two federations, is good, especially also on the youth level. And the more you discuss different ideas, different approaches, Germany can learn from China, China can learn from Germany. And I think this is something that this approach has to be there. And it helps always, it's a win-win situation. It helps always both sides. And that's why I'm happy that the Bundesliga, they have offices in China. It gets to have more exchange, more get together. When I saw the kids playing there in China 3 years ago, I was highly impressed. And I think the more this now is happening on a daily basis, the more they play all over the country, the stronger your entire infrastructure will get. And also at the end, the stronger your national team will get. China was not lucky now to go to Qatar, but then the next World Cup, this is, has to be the goal to go to the World Cup in the United States, Mexico and Canada in 4 years from now. But it all starts with the children playing more.
实际上这个我们过去在德国的球员，我们中国球员去的不少，这个我们最成功的就是我原来的队友杨成在法兰克福。我觉得德国足球能在足坛长盛不衰的原因，实际上就是他的青训做得非常的扎实，他的这个基本功，他的这些非常的好。所以说我很想就是能不能在更深层次的和德国的青训做一些更加深入的这个交流，那么会对我们中国足球是非常大的帮助。德国足球它这个踢得很务实啊，而且非常简练。我觉得他们特别在团队协作上面是非常这个配合啊，是非常严谨的啊。然后呢，但是对于德国足球，我觉得我中国足球更应该学习的是德国的精神，足球精神。往往我觉得德国队在一些特别是世界杯上落后的情况下啊，一些关键场次他始终能打回来。德国他是有历史的啊，这种逆风球他是有历史。中国足球最应该学习的是德国的精神层面的东西，这个是我非常看好德国。